stuck in a kitten, covered in crack ho shit. Horse intestine faked in a casserole, served to some preschool kids. Niggers, kikes, bics, lance, and gooks, let's not give them a pass. If you're insulted, I don't apologize. Suck a gay rhino's ass, and everybody sing fuck, 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 fuck.
When will this bullshit end? I'm going to give you guys a heads up right now. As of this review, I've only watched the first 12 episodes of this anime, and I don't plan on watching any more of it. I am fucking done with this franchise, and everyone keeps trying to give me reasons as to why I should keep giving it a chance. All my fucking Naruto friends keep screaming at me, "Oh, no, 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 come on, Anna, if it's starting to get good, just give it a little bit longer. There's a big fight in the next few episodes." No. No. I am fucking done. This is it. I'm not watching this series anymore, you got it? I'm officially done with Naruto. I draw the fucking line in the sand right here. No. No fucking more. I'm not doing this shit for another 5 fucking years. Naruto is over, okay? It's done to me. I am no longer interested in this bullshit. And I get it, okay? I fucking get it. I get it. It's fucking Naruto. It's popular. Or it was popular, let's say. And for good reason. I can understand the appeal this show has had over the years. It was a good show. A good manga. And it's one of Japan's most beloved and successful long-running franchises today. And I understood that. But a beautiful bitch can only stay beautiful so goddamn long. Before you know it, the cat's hair starts to gray, her smooth skin starts to get wrinkly, and soon you're left with nothing more than a walking wrinkly old bag of fucking menopause and adult diapers. TV Tokyo and Studio Pirate doesn't seem to understand that everything has a fucking expiration date. No matter what it is, okay? People, food, buildings, conservative values, all of it. All of it has to go at a certain point in order to make way for better and more progressive elements. Nothing in this world lasts forever, nor should it. And when it tries to, people will obviously grow out of it or they'll be fucking lost all the progress being made, and eventually, it's going to be left on the side of the road decayed and forgotten. And this is all coming from someone who stopped watching the anime around the beginning of the first Shinobi War arc. I was just so goddamn fed up with trying to torrent this shit, while at the same time fangasming over much better and more mature animes that were coming out at the time. I think Parasite was doing around this time, and I was so far too obsessed with that in order to give any kind of a shit about fucking Naruto. So instead, I just quit watching the anime and focused entirely on the manga. I was just sick of the show, as well as the fucking franchise itself. It matured over the years, yes. It introduced some more serious plot points, such as war, and tagging with very down-to-earth motives that mirrored some real true-to-life issues we all face in the real world. But it all had to end at some point. And the way they ended on a positive note with most, if not every major plot point nicely tied up, was perfect. A big-time villain was defeated, if not the big-time villain, and we had a nice little everyone lived happily ever after moment Naruto and Hanada's wedding in the anime. It was all perfect. There was nothing more to be done with it. But then, just when I thought this shit was finally over with, and TV Tokyo would move on to something new, this shit comes out. Boruto, Naruto, Next Generations, and slaps me in the face proclaiming, "Huh, you thought we were fucking done? Fuck no. We still got 10 more fucking years to milk this fast fucking half for every last drop of milk she's fucking worth." As I'm trying to move, trying to move on to something new and exciting and exploring new waters is somehow illogical and unimaginative. Now, we're gonna suck the tits of this motherfucking cow so fucking dry that its udders are going to screw up like the balls of a fucking beta male pumping the shit out of a fucking reaction fucking Makura. When there is absolutely no fucking reason to do so. There is no reason for this shit to go on. And the fact is the biggest flaw Next Generations is suffering from is that it's doing nothing new to keep fans interested. Or at least fans who are starting to fucking lose interest. And everyone's so quick to point out the minor plus points with interest that fucking differentiates from the previous series, like the new Like, suddenly the Naruto universe has turned all on fucking head because characters are eating fucking fast food instead of ramen. Fucking, oh my god, who the hell gives a fuck? How about the movie overall feel of the anime, the maturity of the characters, and the aesthetics of the setting? Has it matured in any way once so fucking ever? The answer to that would of course be, fuck no. Think of it this way, kiddies. How old were you when the Naruto anime first was released on the internet? Or on fucking Cartoon Network or whatever? All the way back in fucking, what? Like, what was it? Like, 2002 or 2003 or some shit? I don't know. But how old were you then? And how old are you now? How has your viewpoint of the world changed the long 15 years since the shit was first conceived? You probably graduated from feelings such as, oh, girls are so fucking gross and have the cooties, to fucking, oh my fucking god, look at that fucking Asian girl in the summer shorts. I want to shove my middle finger up her fucking bum. Your maturity, or lack thereof maybe, I don't know, has evolved or changed in some form since the early 2000s. And that's why I hate this. My understanding of the world has improved and I'm able to grasp a wider range of topics and ideas. Ideas much more developed and progressive than I would get from any stupid old shonen anime. What we have here cast-wise is all the mutated cum-shark offspring of the previous cast of characters in a post-war modern version of the world where the four screech and newbie nations are now at peace with one another. Thanks to Naruto's efforts and his one day people will truly understand each other's mindset. And while a few of these characters stick close to what their parents were like as kids, such as Shikidai, the son of Shikamaru Tamari, who's close friends with main character Burrito, I'm just gonna call him that throughout the rest of this fucking series because fuck him. But aside from him, some characters threw me for a fucking complete and total fucking loop here. Some of them are almost completely different from how their parents were as kids. Which I guess is anime's way of showing individuality instead of just simply copying and pasting previous versions of the cast. Which I guess works here, but it works in very lame and irritating ways. A few episodes are devoted specifically to getting to know these new cast members, and I was really quite shocked to see Lee's cum shot. You're not to be a bashful, nervous wreck. This shit honestly made me do a fucking double take. I mean, how the fuck is the offspring of something like this? You would think Rock Lee would be teaching his son the little power of youth thing and seizing the moment like my guy taught him. But no, nothing like that here. He's a nervous fucking bundle of marshmallows and cheese whiz. Too bad I don't see Rock Lee interacting with his little boy anywhere in the first 12 episodes. I'm sure we all want to learn how he feels about this fucking bundle of nerves for a child. But no, Rock Lee is nowhere to be seen here in the anime, as of yet at least the momentary chunk I watched. And as for the other kids that are the offspring of the previous cast, they're not even really worth mentioning. The fat-ass daughter of Choji and Kurai never had that much screen time to think of, except in maybe one episode, and whenever she was on screen, it was almost always a comical fucking antic that had no relevance to the overarching plot. The only cast members that got more snippets of screen time here were the kids of the major cast members, such as Serena and a group of girlfriends, as well as Mitsuki. And the funny thing about Mitsuki, is this anime likes to pretend that we don't already know who he is and how he came to be. You see, another thing that makes this TV anime suck is that it treats the Burrito movie as if it never fucking happened. As in all the students here are just now starting at the Ninja Academy. Whereas in the movie, the cast were all on their teams as full-fledged fucking ninja taking the tuning exams. Which is stupid as we all know the movie was based on canon material. This on the other hand is not. Yep, this shit is just more fucking filler. Meaning everything that was awesome showing the Burrito movie isn't here. The anime, as of now, does not follow the spin-off manga at all. Cool things of Sarada-Uchiha's Sharingan is nowhere to be seen here in the TV anime. Which really pissed me the fuck off because I fucking love Sarada's Sharingan. I mean, look at this fucking Sharingan. Fucking lit. You might be saying, AMF, it's just the first stage of Sharingan. We've seen it before. It's old. And it truly has been done before, but one, this is the first time we've seen a female actually use the Sharingan. And no, I'm not counting Nori because that was also stupid cheesy ass filler and wasn't fucking canon. And two, I have a fucking glasses fetish, therefore I fucking love how Kishimoto made sure about fucking Megane. Seriously, when she first released her Sharingan in the movie together with sporting them glasses, holy fucking shit. Instant fucking city. Getting a sexy Megan and Sharon on a wacky TV anime is really fucking unforgivable. Yes, her own being sexy-ass Megan is one thing, but fuck, you had to take away the one thing that made her even sexier. And yes, I do know she's fucking 12 years old in the movie, and honestly, I don't fucking care. Look at this fucking Sharingan! Seriously, I'm fucking pedo-burying the fuck out of Sarada and a Sharingan. But sadly, his Sharingan wasn't anywhere to be seen here. She has yet to awaken in this non-canon bullshit. Whether it'll start hearing the manga later, I don't fucking know. But as of what I watched, it's all been non-canon filler. And filler was already one of the most pointless and irritating aspects of Naruto anime suffered from. Yet, they're still doing it here, and I'm fucking sick of it. As for all the other previous heroes that we've all come to know and love, they've all now taken background parenting roles no different than what you see from a fucking mom and dad character in any other anime ever. The only time we see Shikamaru is at home welcoming Shikadai home. And while Naruto spends a lot of time on screen, he's always too busy with his job as Hokage to pay any amount of attention to fucking Burrito. Which is a source of a lot of Burrito's anguish here. And unlike his pop, Burrito has no aspiration to follow in his father's footsteps, and instead pretty much wants to be the right-hand man to a certain future Hokage. Or in this manga's case, like Sasuke. Which honestly kind of struck me as weird. I mean, the son of Konoha's number one unpredictable knucklehead ninja wants to become a ninja like fucking Konoha's number one world ninja traitor Psycho? Okay, whatever. But anyway, the overreaching plot of this filler falls Burrito as he one day witnesses some kind of ghost thing possess one of his classmates through some kind of bizarre new ocular jutsu that only he can use. And after dealing with the first appearance, this ghost slowly begins spreading all throughout the village and possess people who are feeling emotionally fucked and thus causing them to chimp out like black dudes at a fucking BLM rally. And since Burrito is the only one capable of seeing these ghosts, he takes it upon himself to uncover just what these ghosts are and what their goal is. All the while leaving his father and other adults protagonists of the past out of the loop for no logical reason, other than to preserve his position as the story's fucking lead. And there are two things this story suffers from aside from the fact that it's all still the same fucking Naruto. First of all, it's boring. The only exciting part was that well-animated forward in the beginning of the first episode where an older Burrito is fighting the Kawaki guy. A scene meant to specifically give me all fucking hype for the series to come. But since that was a snippet of the future that we're most likely not going to see a conclusion for anytime soon, at least for several hundred episodes, it lacks any real relevance and it's over as quickly as it fucking began. Then we're introduced to this, the actual plot. And compared to the previous Naruto where it was all about an overarching goal and a day-by-day, chapter-by-chapter struggle to grow and fight much more stronger opponents and eventually ending a world that's constantly plagued by war, as well as vividly showing us that world, we find that none of that shit's here. Here's like the fucking ninja anime version of fucking Scooby-Doo or some shit, solving a fucking mystery involving ghosts. All of the things that made Naruto a great story is either gone here, or shown in such minuscule fucking detail, they're extremely easy to fucking miss. Either that or the plot is too goddamn hard to fully build up to the point worthy of fucking watching. Our lead character has no real long-term goal, the shinobi world's at peace, and top it all off, this entire anime is just, in fact, more fucking filler. Even the animation here was disappointing. All things considered, this still has the same Naruto aesthetic to it, but the thing is, though, that isn't a fucking compliment. This is still done by everyone's favorite studio pirate, and since Naruto has always had a history of jumping between animation heads, directors, and staff in general, pinpointing and staying with one director is never an easy task. But as of this review, the director has been Noriyuki Abe, who's pretty much worked on every other major pirate work, including Bleach and a few of the Bleach movies. And since they often bounce between directors and animators specifically for some of the more action-oriented scenes or episodes, there are no doubt going to be the ones that look most different, and possibly better than others. But if Naruto of the past has been anything to go by so far, that's not always a good thing. Please, for the love of God, keep whoever directed episode 167 on a leash. Six Tails vs. Pain was by far the most disappointed by the entire fucking anime. And aside from the forward shot showing that fight is supposedly going to happen in the future, no fights to that has better than the other. In fact, they've all been pretty fucking boring so far. And the character designs here are still very fucking Naruto, which again, isn't a compliment. A few of them stood out to me, but not in a positive manner. For example, why is character Sumire Kakai wearing a Serifuku uniform? I don't know why, but I couldn't stop staring at this little bitch's outfit. She just felt so goddamn out of place running at a fucking Naruto spinoff. And personality-wise, she's like this generation's fucking Hinata. Bashful and self-conscious. Basically making her pretty much a copy-paste of every shy character in every mainstream anime fucking ever. And the design for Iwabe Yuno, who for some reason hates the piece brought on by all of Naruto's hard work, was probably the most off-putting character of them all. I hated looking at him with a fucking red-ass cap of his. And I'll admit, I like the designs of a few other characters, such as this girl, for example, but the problem with her is that she's a background character with little to no screen time in the 12 episodes I watched, and only offered a few lines that consisted mostly of dissing Greedo alongside Sarada and her gal pals. As for the overall quality of the animation, it was average when comparing it between the various animators who worked on the anime in the past, and there was no sign of Asuka, Mamezuka, or Masa Onishi anywhere here, who had a hand in both the Power Arc as well as several Naruto and Bleach movies, and would have no doubt increased the quality of the fighting by a fucking 100. The animation during the fight scene in the fight episode of Power Arc was more fluidly animated than most of the entire anime combined. Effects like fire, explosion, that fucking high-detail piranha gave the battle a dark, somber mood, and was absolutely fucking phenomenal to watch. And it remained consistent throughout all 5 episodes. But not only were Asuka and Mayasa not present here for Next Generations, the fights themselves were against some of the dumbest looking opponents ever. Do not even get me started on the fight between Greedo, Sarada, and Kagemase. This shit is just so fucking done, you know? Naruto feels fucking done. I'm one of those consumers who understands very clearly that nothing lasts forever, ever. Hell, there's no doubt in my mind that even Attack on Titan is going to become old and dead after a decade or two. It's currently one of the best fucking animes in the entire world right now, but so is Inuyasha, and everyone forgot about that franchise damn quick. And it proved that everything becomes dated after a time. Things change, and it needs to if you want to move on and grow. Next Generation shows clearly that Pirate doesn't want to do that. If this showed Greedo fresh out of the fucking academy as a full-fledged ninja and pursuing his own long-reaching aspiration that he fucking believed in, instead of just trying to solve a stupid little ghost mystery, I would have probably been willing to give this more of a chance. But it didn't. I gave the anime 12 episodes to impress me except my normal 5 because it's fucking Naruto, and I wanted to give it a chance no matter how dated it felt. But unfortunately, it failed. There is nothing new here that adds to the franchise. At all. It's just the same shit, all over again. Sorry all you Narutos out there, but Greedo, Naruto Next Generations, gets a flat out fucking 3.8 out of 10 for me. It gets the facepalm seal of approval. This franchise is dead. It needs to end. I would recommend this shit to serious high-level Naruto fans. You know, the kind of people who claim to be anime fans yet watch only fucking Naruto. And if you still want Naruto after all these years, well, here you go. More fucking Naruto. Same old, same old. Give this shit a watch for the next 5 or 6 years. Hell, knowing Naruto will probably win even longer than that. But if you're sick of this shit, or were at least satisfied with how Shippuden ended, or that one OVA of Naruto and Hinata getting hitched, then leave it there. It's time for some serious fucking fan discontinuity. There is no reason to waste any more money on this franchise. If you want to, fine, keep wasting your money. But even if I was still a Naruto fan, I would still say you should just start torrenting the episodes for free. We need to show TV Tokyo this franchise is fucking dead. And the only way to do that is a coffer full of cash. And that's just coming from us, let's face it. We need to show them that we want a new long-running series. And if they do it right, it can be just as fun, interesting, and as lucrative as Naruto ever was. And in case you're wondering, yes, I am very excited for Kishimoto's new sci-fi manga. Mostly because it looks like he's moving on to something more mature looking. At least I think. I don't know. It looks like more mecha bullshit, to be honest. But if it does something new and creative, then I'll probably review it and probably score something pretty high. And doing something new would be a logical step to make, and Kishimoto is taking that logical step. Because Asians are of course smarter than white guys and know when to abandon a dead project for a new one. Just like his fan base has grown more mature in the many, many years since the manga was first released, Kishimoto has moved on. It's time we did too. And with that, I'm fucking done. If you like this video, at the very least find my ignorance entertaining and hit subscribe on watching this on YouTube, or anywhere else for that matter, other than my blog, do not subscribe to me here. Find the link to my blog in the video description below. The videos I post here, I'll post there too. And if by some stretch of the imagination that you like me and like what I do, head over to my Patreon page and donate a few bucks. And until next time, fellow human filth, I'm the ignorance hit was free. And I just don't give a fuck.
Just stop! Just stop it! Protective Services, it's time to stop!